Hello, this is H.C. Bailey, and welcome to the finale on Let's Play Final Fantasy IX! What do you mean by that? Yeah, that's genetic memory. And what is that source? Huh. So why can't we remember anything beyond our own lifetime? Oh. That's weird. Well, that would be a problem. Crystal? I thought the crystal was, like, shattered or destroyed with Alexander. What do you mean by that? Well, I'll take care of him. I'll take care of him real good. What crystal? Wait! Explain, Garland! Well, that's the last we're hearing of him, I guess. Well, apparently so was I. And of course, like every good Final Fantasy game, you have to have the final area being a crystal-like area or something. So, let's take a look around. And get into random battles with... What the? I thought I already killed these guys! Well, actually, in the crystal world, just like Final Fantasy V, all the enemies here give no experience, but they give a ton of ability points. So, what I want to do is, because they still have the same attacks and pretty much the same HP, really. So what I want to do is use Soul Blade with Sergeant Tannis just to knock them out, because I'm not going to get the experience from them anyway. And that should do it. Alright, got them. But yeah, you can fight any of the four fiends here. They give 7 ability points, no experience regardless. By the way, if I didn't say so before, a petrified enemy, they give no experience. Regardless of whether they normally would or not. So, just something for you to keep in mind, viewers. Like, if you were thinking about doing that against Grand Dragon. Yeah, if you want to use Grand Dragons for, like, level grinding, use level 5 death. Fortunately, this part is not very long at all. Okay, here we are. We've made it to the final save point. You can also teleport out of here if you want to, but I don't want to do that. I just want to rearrange my party for the final battles! Soon enough, viewers. Okay, we're all set and ready to go. I've rearranged my party as I have listed in the video description there. And I'll go over why I made all my decisions and everything like that, well, as we go. What's that behind you there? Oh, so that's why we had to fight those guys all over again, huh? Nuts. Where'd you find that? Why haven't you done that already, then, if you're so, what's the word? Nihilistic? Is that the word? Eh, whatever. Not quite as nihilistic as Kefka, but you take what you can get. Well, we almost beat you the last time. Nuts. I thought you destroyed Terra. Huh. Well, we can still take you out. Yeah, I mean, it's pretty hard to destroy a planet. I mean, to destroy the entire planet, you know? Not just wiping out all life on the planet, that's easy. But, I mean, to actually destroy an entire planet, that's pretty hard. What are we a sacrifice for? Boss time! Alright, yeah, we're not taking on Kuja just yet. I guess he has some minions he wants us to fight first. Or is it? Are we just fighting space? Oh, there we go. Whoa. Looks just like that other guy we fought earlier, Gizmaluke, huh? Odd they would choose him to make a palette swap of, but, well, there we go. Oh, whoa, watch out for Meteor. This is why I have auto life on everyone, because it will kill you! Okay, it can kill you! Because, it can deal, like, max damage, so damage is such a wide variety, or a wide range of damage. And the other thing that I've done is I've got auto-regen on everyone, not just auto-life, because all, I don't know about this guy, but I know all of the remaining bosses that we have to fight have no wait time at all. And it's just ridiculous to go, you know, attack, heal, wait for his attack, heal, wait for his attack. You know, you're getting like one attack in per round, practically, because the final bosses are just so fast. So I figure, you know what, let's just go with auto-regen. I don't care if it circumvents, you know, the need for healing or whatever. Let's just get it on. And also, meteors, grossly unfair. Maybe I should get a little bit of healing going there. Ow. But yeah, I like throwing wing edges because all the final bosses are flying and it deals massive damage to them, almost max damage. It's not worth using power throw at all. So don't worry about that. But yeah, let's get a little more healing there just in case he decides to throw meteors up my ass. Or on my head, either way. Yeah, I almost got max damage on Thievery before the end of the game. Close enough. Oh, yeah, we got a trance coming up here. I forget exactly how that works for him. It does something to his... Oh, we got multiple trances. That's great. I forget exactly how the trance works for Amarant there. I know it does something. Well, it increases his stats so he can deal max damage, so that's nice. But, yeah, it does... changes his flare to Alon, whatever that means, I don't know, but well, there we go. All right, we got him. Well, you made it too easy on us, Kuja. And like all good bosses, what'd you do that for, Kuja? Killed your own guy. That wasn't very nice. Well, we got him anyway, so... Now, the nice thing about this part is that you can actually leave, then come to use a tent and rest up and come back. So I'm going to do that. Be right back. Okay, I've rested up back at the save point there for the final battle against Kuja. Or, well, Trance Kuja now, himself. How do you know that you're out of time, Kuja? For boss time! You've got plenty of time for boss time. Now, he's not really that much harder than he was the first time we fought him. But he does have kick-ass final boss music, so gotta appreciate that. A little different than his normal theme. We will rock you. But yeah, pretty much the same thing as before. Now that he can fly, he's more susceptible to wing edges. Thanks, Kuja, for flying. Thank you for flying. You may be experiencing some turbulence. Ha ha! We hope you've enjoyed the ride! Ha ha! Yeah! Kick ass! This is how you do a final boss theme. Yeah. But yeah, really, not too much in the way of strategy because I've got auto regen and auto life going on everyone. The interesting thing about Zidane is that because of his, I think it's his spirit stat, if I'm not mistaken, he regenerates very, very, very quickly. Or at least a lot more at a time. So, that's pretty nice there. But yeah, I got like, what, 50, 60,000 HP. Not too much to worry about. Uh-oh, Flare Star. If I didn't say so before, it deals damage equal to your level times 50. So, but we should be able to survive. And it doesn't have a very good hit percentage, apparently. How'd you get in two attacks? Yeah, you see, this is what I mean. When the bosses have, like, no wait time, they can just do attack after attack after attack. So even if you enter in a whole bunch of commands at once, it still won't help you that much. So that's why I have no problem at all of using auto-regen here. I think Holy would go through his Reflect there. And yeah, I know, I forgot earlier. I could have, what is it? I could have equipped Garnet, or, well, Dagger, Sarah, whatever her name is. I could have equipped her with Reflect Null, and that would actually let your spells go through Reflect. That might have been useful. Maybe I could have thought about that more, but, well, whatever. Yeah, Eiko would be fine. You can handle the flare, can't you? Yeah, there you go. By the way, I've got Eiko equipped with the magic racket there, because it boosts holy elemental damage, but it also boosts your magic stat a little bit. Alright, we got it! What do you mean by that? Don't do it, Kuja! Don't destroy the crystal! Or you could cast Ultima again. Nuts. Not again. And they die. Well, all right. We got them. That's it. Game's over. It is over, isn't it? Or are we dead? What happened? Whoa, what's with all that moaning in the background? That's like really creepy. Are we in hell? We might be. What happened? Is this what happened? Oh. I guess Kuja did destroy the crystal. Nuts. Or maybe. I don't know. We're still around, though, so. Well, yeah, that's kind of what happens. I sense much fear in you, yes. God, the game's not even trying to pretend that it's not quoting Star Wars here. Or whatever Yoda was quoting there. Who is this guy anyway? It's not Kuja. No, that was just him. Just because he's suicidal doesn't mean the rest of us are. What do you mean? Well, it wouldn't be a Final Fantasy game without the unexpected final boss fight. But would you have it any other way, viewers? Would you really? Yeah, it's not over yet, viewers. I don't think so. We are still alive, aren't we? I want to continue scratching my ass for a long time, thank you very much. When did you get some nobles, Zidane? How are we going to do that? Everyone else doesn't seem to be doing too well there. I'm going to fight and, well, live at the same time. Oh, great, we're at 1 HP. What are we going to do now? I'm just going to keep the same party for this part, that's okay. Yeah, you get a little different dialogue depending on who you choose for this part, but nothing too major. Yeah, give your powers to Quina. That's a great idea, Steiner. One fat man to another, huh? Yeah, I don't think we need Vivi for this part. And from 1 6-year-old to another. Wonder if that's a coincidence. And one more. Ah, thanks for your, So I finally get in your pants after all this time. Nah. Alright, is that it? Yeah, we're all healed up and ready to go for the final battle! We're not gonna lose now!